What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome to another episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Hope you guys are doing well this evening. I'm your host, Rob Bertrand. Joining me as always, we have Chris Stuber and the man behind the scenes, James Gale. How are you guys doing tonight?
Doing well, Rob. How you doing? Happy Thursday to everybody. Hope everybody's having a good week. Good week.
Absolutely.
So far.
Yeah. Absolutely. Tomorrow is Happy Friday. So
always.
Happy Friday Eve to everyone.
I could do a dance in my chair in my own house and sing if I want to, Rob. We can have some fun.
You don't even need a reason.
No one's here to even stare at me weird.
We made an oops last week. First and foremost, we forgot to give away the BCW card frame, so we'll be sure to do that at the end of the show when we award other prizes this evening. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 box breaks, including two world premieres, and one we're calling a sneak peek world premiere, sure, because this thing has gotten pushed back like again and again and again. And so
almost
we'll talk
30
more,
times, Rob, I would say.
Yeah. We'll talk more about that later. We have several cool stories and hobby happenings to go over, in addition to this week's new releases that we might look at during our break segment. We'll detail other products in Hot in the Shop. Got a couple great video segments and some surprises. So we're going to kick things off, as always, with our Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll.
Just not for me from that standpoint. I don't really necessarily have to commemorate through a card that way.
Okay. Well, you have to remember that it's not all commemoration. I mean, remember the Topps Living Sets?
Yes.
I think you missed out some good opportunities on some WWE cards, especially since they're print to order.
Sure.
You never know what the print run's going to be.
The Panini one they have out there for the WWE ones, I believe. Yeah. So, yeah.
So I have purchased Topps WWE Living Set, a couple cards direct on
Did
release.
You?
Yeah, definitely.
So, who'd you get? Just curious.
Pretty sure it was Trish Stratus.
I don't blame you.
Yeah.
My favorite.
You can't go wrong with the little Stratus faction.
Cannot.
You know what I mean? Know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
Absolutely. So weigh in on that if you guys haven't already, and we'll update the poll question later in the show. As I mentioned last week, we gave away two awesome swag bags from the National. We have one more to give away.
Sure.
Chris, what do they need to do to be eligible to win this jam-packed swag bag?
It's very simple, really. Just go on Go GTS Live's Twitter account and hit the retweet button. And at the end of the show, we will announce the winner.
We love bringing back stuff from the National to people that can't make the National. So this is our way of being able to share the National with you. One thing about our Twitter giveaways, that's how we aggregate the giveaways for the hits from our box breaks and other things. So you have to be following us on Twitter
requirement.
The program that we use automatically kicks you out. And so you don't want to have retweeted something and realized you weren't following us. So if you aren't following Go GTS Live on Twitter, be sure to do that.
You get the boot out of the club. If you're in the club, you follow us. It's very
simple. Yeah. That's right.
That's it.
All right, let's dive into some news, notes, and nuggets from around the web. And we're going to kick things off in our hobby happening segment with a little bit of an update to a story we talked about last week with regards to the 86-87 Fleer NBA basketball box break giveaway hosted by Whatnot at this year's National. After Sports Card Radio reported on irregularities with the collation of the box and then responded to Baseball Card Exchange, who authenticated the box, Whatnot sent the following message to winners from the original box, saying Whatnot has been made aware by the community of concerns with the 1986-87 Fleer basketball box opened and given away at this year's National. Our intention at the National was to give back to the community that we love. So it's in that spirit we partnered with Golden and will be opening a second box of 1986 Fleer basketball live on Whatnot. You will receive a pack of 86 Fleer from this box for free. Wow. So obviously you can tell that this went out to the winners from the previous box.
Sure.
So this streamed live last night at 8 o'clock, and they went on to say, let us know if you have any questions. Thank you, Whatnot team. So
that's really cool.
Seems that all's well that ends well.
Well, of course. So that's the hobby, right? That's what we love. Check this out. Have you heard about the free 2022-2023 football pick'em contest that BCW Supplies is hosting this year? It's pretty cool. Each week of the NFL season and postseason, BCW will offer a nice football card-related prize to the group participant that predicts the most NFL game winners. To participate, simply, one, create an account on cbssports.com and sign in or use the CBS Sports app. Two, navigate to the 2022 Football Pick'em and join them, the BCW Supplies pool. Three, each week of the NFL season and postseason, make your game predictions for a chance to win great prizes. It's that easy. A very nice gesture from BCW. Go check it out and win some prizes.
Nice. Well, it really is amazing that despite the history of this hobby, the advances in communication technology and the rise of social media, that previously unknown or little known sports card sets can still be discovered. But a recent post by Sports Collectors Daily proves it's true. A rare Diego Maradona card set has surfaced 4 decades after it was first printed in Spain. Wow. The unique 50-card issue is actually a puzzle of Maradona, who is shown wearing his Argentina national team jersey during the international friendly match played against England in May of 1980. According to Miami Sports Cards, the puzzle card sets were produced by Matteo Moretti of Spain and were sold via packs or included as prizes inside pouches of pipe tobacco.
Wow.
Once the cards were attached to the pre-printed album page, they could then be exchanged for a prize, typically a soccer ball. And that's a major part of the reason why complete or near complete sets are nearly unheard of these days. This is the second known to exist, the second known complete puzzle set to exist. Miami Sports Card says it took a collector nearly all of the last 42 years to assemble the puzzle set.
I can very cool. imagine. That's quite a journey. It really is.
Do me a favor, Chris.
Yeah.
Read this slow. This video that you're talking over is 50 seconds long.
No problem. Stakeholders in fractional shares on the collectible app can now sync their portfolio to Alton Insights account for detailed tracking and folder analysis of market pricing data. As seen in this video, users can easily upload their investment portfolio from collectible and begin tracking their sports collectibles investments with detailed analytics, charts, and graphs powered by Alton Insights. At a simple glance, stakeholders can monitor daily price action, performance, and more with easy-to-use and intuitive dashboards already known to those familiar with Alton Insights. Very, very cool.
It is very cool. In fact, I haven't had a reason to always go on Alton Insights, but I am going to take advantage of this because I do have a portfolio on collectible apps. So I'm going to actually see how all that works. I think that's pretty cool.
It's really nice to see that portfolio go up now, just have all that information right in front of you. That's awesome.
Absolutely. Well, next up, eBay, which is still the world's largest seller of trading cards, has implemented several new services to help collectors and protect both buyers and sellers. The key thing there being and sellers. Seems like for far too long, everything skewed to the buyer.
Yes.
Including steps the company has taken to address shill bidding. Director of Trading Cards Bob Means recently discussed the new programs and the sports card market with Sports Collectors Digest editor Jeff Owens. Be sure to check out the full article and interview on sportscollectorsdigest.com.
That's great. The latest kids crate from Panini America will be hitting local retailers soon. Series 5 includes several great products, including Mosaic Basketball, Dunruss UFC, Rookies and Stars Football, Prism Draft Picks Basketball, Prism Premier League Soccer, and more. If you are a parent looking for something affordable for your kids, be sure to check with your LCS to see if they'll be carrying it. That's such a great cause. I love it.
I do too. And if they're not carrying it, be sure to ask why. They may not be aware of it. Chances are they are, though.
Give them a stern look. Make it happen.
Yeah. You know, I've heard that parents will, you know, it's a great gift idea, or they save it and the individual products, they shell out a little, you know, one at a time, or incentivize for, you know, doing their chores or a good report card. So
it's great.
Yeah,
it's always great to get the kids involved with this hobby that we all love. The kids are very important for this hobby to succeed.
Absolutely. Well, one of these things is not like the other. Remember that? But yet they are the same. Sports Collectors Daily reports that an astute observation by a collector resulted in Golden Auctions voiding the sale of this Tom Brady rookie ticket autographed card pictured on the right after it sold for $54,000 this past Sunday. SC Daily explains that using a tip from a source that wasn't identified, a collector posted a video Sunday of a 2000 playoff contenders Tom Brady rookie autograph card that appeared to show the card had been altered.
Oh, wow.
The card had originally been graded a 6 by PSA, but appears to have possibly been cracked from its holder, altered, and then submitted for regrading. It passed authentication again and was given a near mint 8 grade with an autograph grade of 9. A video posted on YouTube by Something Sports Cards offered evidence that the two cards were one and the same by matching Brady's signatures and detailing several small identical print flaws, some of which had somehow been concealed after the initial grade of 6 was awarded. With those edge and print flaws mitigated, the card received a higher grade when it was apparently submitted again. In addition to Golden voiding the sale, PSA has also deactivated that certification number.
Wow. That's pretty big news right there. In hobby-related business news, a major acquisition has transpired. eBay announced that they have acquired TCG Player for $295 million. TCG Player provides brick-and-mortar shops as well as private sellers a host of tools to increase buyer reach through its online platform. Despite being devoted strictly to gaming cards, as we reported this past March, the company announced that they would be making a strong push into the sports card market this summer. Despite the acquisition, TCG Player will continue to operate autonomously. A press release by eBay stated that the acquisition complements eBay's focused category strategy and furthers the company's commitment to trading card enthusiasts, providing eBay with strategic omnichannel capabilities like order fulfillment and cart optimization, maintaining its position as a desirable platform for trading card sellers and enhancing the overall experience for all customers. That's good news. Yeah.
In crime news, the Atlantic City Prosecutor's Office has charged a Willoughby, Ohio man with second-degree theft by unlawful taking. What a weird unlawful taking.
I thought Atlantic City at first.
And second-degree theft by deception after allegedly stealing over $87,000 in sports cards from Gizmo Sports Cards at this year's National Sports Collectors Convention. Russell Porter faces a maximum sentence of 10 to 20 years in prison for this alleged crime.
Well, good. They got him, right? They got him. Beckett announced that it has officially launched the Beckett Vault, a secure storage solution for collectibles in a climate-controlled, insured facility protected by a 24-hour security. Items stored in the vault can be viewed anywhere in the world from the palm of a user's hand, with high-res images of cards, comics, or memorabilia available instantaneously. The vault features biometric access, water and fireproof storage, and 24/7 monitoring by security experts. And its inaugural collection includes over $3 million worth of collectibles. The vault will launch with zero storage fees, and in time, Vault customers will be able to buy and sell collectibles instantly via the Beckett Marketplace. Once an item is bought or sold, the ownership title is immediately transferred via blockchain technology. The Beckett Vault is open and accepting submissions today and will occupy a portion of Beckett's new 100,000 plus square foot facility in Plano, Texas.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Vaulting is all the rage.
That's it.
Our friends at Onyx Authenticated will be making their Loop debut tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, and we'll be ripping into some art cards live on the Loop app. Don't miss out on this opportunity to secure some gorgeous product for yourself. Download the Loop apps. You'll be ready to go by steering your browser to loop.cards/loop. Also from Loop, you've undoubtedly seen these types of game quizzes on social media, but this is the first one I've seen related to the hobby. So I thought it would be fun if we each tally our score as we tick these off. You okay. too, James. And obviously play along at home. The yes. highest possible score is 17. So you ready?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Hit an auto. One
yes.
point if you hit an auto. Hit a 101.
No.
Open non-sports card.
Yes.
Bought cards from your local card shop.
Yes.
Bought into a break.
Yes.
Bought cards at a big box retailer.
Yes.
Got an item signed in person.
Of course.
Given cards as a gift.
Yes.
Sent a card in for grading.
Yes.
Cracked a slab.
Of course.
Chewed the bubble gum from a wax pack.
Yes.
Attended a local card show.
Yes.
Attended the national.
Yes.
Held a card worth more than you make in a year.
Yes.
Own a card older than you.
Yes.
Own a card with a woman sports figure.
Of course.
Spend $1,000 or more on a single card.
Yes.
All right. So you had
one. Six, I did not.
16.
Yep.
I also had 16.
Did you? Okay.
So you have not hit a one of one.
Unfortunately, I have not.
I have not spent $1,000 or more on a single card.
Okay.
James, what did you score? Oh, okay. All right. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. Be sure
that was fun. That was a fun.
Be sure to let us know if you got a perfect score of 17. Share it in the chat. All right, James, what did you score?
I do have a perfect score of 17.
Do you? Wow, really? That is fantastic. Yes. I love it.
Done, sir. Mm-hmm.
So, I almost feel ashamed I have not hit a 101. I guess I just don't buy a lot of packs though. I buy a lot of single cards. That's just
there you go.
My jam. I do a lot of box breaks here and there. Just haven't got that 101 yet.
Yeah, I'm fine with that. I haven't spent over $1,000 on a single card. I have kids.
I guess
you don't have kids. You know, you have a little more discretionary income than I do, probably. So.
And it also helps the wife trust me with my judgment.
There you go.
So that's also a good thing. So she allows me to not have free reign, but she allows me to do what I do.
That's awesome. I have a pretty supportive wife, too. But
that's
good. There are boundaries.
There are. Like, I'll show her the cards that I buy. And she'll just give me, like, an eye.
Makes you happy, Chris.
That's really all it is. Like, I showed you a Trish Stratus card I got in the mail yesterday. I showed it to her. She goes, really? And she gives it back. it's almost like that look, and then it's like, oh, really?
Does she like WWE? Will she watch it?
She'll tolerate it with me. I've just been watching it since I was like 6 years old, almost as long as I've been watching baseball and playing baseball. So it's those two things, wrestling and baseball.
They came with the Chris Stuber package.
And I love all the other sports too. As you know, Rob, I have a background in football. So, I mean, I've just been a big sports head my whole life. So, and sports cards help that. So if anyone's watching, sports cards allow you to get into sports and grow that passion. That's what it's all about.
Right. That's right. All right. Well, speaking of some sports cards, why don't we dive into our box break segment for the evening? And yes, so if you have young children that don't want exposed to Benchwarmer trading cards, we're going to get this out of the way first. You can.
Is this PG-13 or is this, is it like,
It's PG-13.
14 and up? Okay, PG-13.
It's PG-13. Okay. There's no nudity.
Okay, so it's, if you have kids,
this is
risque girls.
Best of Benchwarmer. This is a product 2 years in the making. It was supposed to release last year, and they went back to the drawing board because they wanted to pack out more value at a lower price. Nice. How often do you hear that?
Not much. And also on Go GTS Live's Twitter account, I just put a tweet out there. So if anyone who is watching, I hope a lot of people are watching, go to the Go GTS Live Twitter account and retweet the tweet that was just sent out that starts with, who's ready for box break? So I know Rob is, so he's ready to dive into these bench warmers.
Okay.
I don't blame him. I get to have front row seats right here, just like everybody else.
Get my glasses.
I told Rob I was going to wear my finest robe for tonight, but it's at the cleaners, unfortunately.
All right. Let's start here.
Surprise. Is that like a jewelry box? Is that like velvet inside there?
Yeah.
Is that nice velvet?
Yep. Velveteen.
It's fitting.
Caramonico, numbered 5 of 5. Best butts.
Okay.
Best butts.
She has a nice derriere. Sure.
While we're on butts, why don't we go to a 2 of 2 with Val Keel?
She takes her vitamins, Rob.
So there's 4 base cards, all numbered really low. Lisa Gleave, number 2 of 4. You guys might remember her from what's the briefcase game?
It's with Howie Mandel.
Deal or no deal. That's right. She was a briefcase girl for years.
Nice.
Best Footsteps, Miss Holly Madison, one of the girls next door.
I'm very familiar with her.
Number 2 of 5. I don't want to know how familiar you are with her.
I wish I was that familiar, Rob, but Hef got a lot more familiar.
The only Sarah Underwood, Best Footsteps, numbered 3 of 4.
This would be a set my wife would give me crooked eyes with.
Yeah, I'm sure. You and me both.
But I would be happy.
Actually, it's one base card. And then those other ones were parallel. Lisa Durgan.
She sounds familiar.
Yeah, she does.
Lisa Durgan. Very familiar. Well, we got some autographs.
Brandy Moses, numbered 3 of 5. Oh, wow. That's a nice one right there. Cindy Bartolis, numbered 4 of 5.
Yeah, I would say I had a crush on her back in the day.
Who didn't?
Oh, my God.
At one time, her claim to fame was, what, the most downloaded woman on the internet?
Yeah, she was. You kids at home, don't go and Google her.
And Angela Fong, numbered 1 of 3. So, two really solid autos.
I would say so. The Margolis is fantastic. What's that numbered out of? 5?
Yep, numbered 4 of 5. They're both numbered to 5.
Gorgeous.
So, we'll go ahead and give the Cindy two prize packs. I'll split the cards up. One gets the Cindy Margolis. Another gets the Brandy Moses. Best of Benchwarmer.
The Margolis is fantastic. Yeah. Are you okay over there, Hot Hands?
I am. Okay. I'm just making sure I got everything.
You'll have sweaty hands over there now, right?
No, I'm good. I'm good. Okay. All right. Let's see. Next up. This is our sneak peek world premiere. What's the official date of release of this now, Chris? Wild card Matt 2022 draft pick football cards.
It's changed so many times on me, Rob.
I know. I think it's...
I want to say it's September 2nd. That sounds like...
Is it next week? Okay, cool.
Let me take a look really quick.
So wild card Matt football has... 6 packs, 8 cards per pack, and 4 autograph cards.
Yeah, wild card comes out September 2nd. It's a Friday.
All right. So this is the very first box.
Yeah, it really is. This is beautiful to come out like this for us. Wild card has done a great job since coming back. If you're really into shiny cards and things that stand out, I mean, their technology's been great. The gloss, I saw Illumination and I was pretty impressed with what they did with that product.
Even the box has a nice...
Right. Yeah, and I go off of sell sheets too. Sell sheets that they give us are pretty nicely done. So, they've really stepped up their marketing.
One chase pack per 5. Wow. Okay. So look for low numbered insert cards and parallels in the green chase packs.
Yep.
And approximately 1 in every 5 boxes are guaranteed a chase pack. And we did get one. We'll save that for last.
Nice.
My eyes.
So 4 autograph cards per box here, Rob. You remember the stripes that Wildcard did? They have the stripes in this. Remember back in the day?
The original parallel.
Yeah, yeah. They're really sweet. Really, really cool cards.
All right. Daniel Falafel.
You want some falafels?
Baliel. Christian Harris, Billy Zapp, Jermaine Johnson the second.
He's a Jet.
Kennedy Brooks.
Yeah.
Snoop Connor.
Love the name. Oh, we got
first
auto.
Auto. Christian Harris, numbered to 100.
Nice.
And Explode. Oh, insert cool. Of Zonathan Knight, numbered 25 of 25.
So, Rob, give me sort of a detail of the card. So, is it a matte finish, obviously, with
yes.
a little gloss on the player? Is that what
yes.
it looks like? Okay.
Very much so.
Nice. Probably perfect for autographs, I would imagine, with that matte finish on there.
Yes.
So that was part of the checklist. Did you get a card autographed in person? These would be great for autographs in person.
Malik Willis. Nicholas Pyatt. For free.
Oh, I like that name.
Sincere McCormick.
I like that. That's nice.
Treylon Burks.
Yeah, he's a stud.
Jaquan Brisker. Mike Rose.
Oh, what's that thing back there? Oh, we got something. Oh, another one. Oh, that's a nice one.
Trayvon Walker, numbered to 50.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's the number one pick in the draft.
Sure is.
That's a great one right there, 25.
50. 25.
Oh, 50. I got you. Yeah. 50. That's a cool one.
Read what is that?
That's a Weekend Warrior one, right?
Weekend Warrior. Trey McBride, numbered to 100.
That's
like
a nice
that.
Card. Yeah, that Trayvon Walker is a nice one. That's a cool looking card. Design. That's a nice Trayvon Walker, though. That was a bang. That was a boom. I saw some people say booms.
Boom!
That was a boom. So Firehand struck.
Chris Steele. I don't like having to turn my head to the side. I don't like when the orientation of the names is vertical. Kyle Phillips. Rather it be smaller and on either side or at the bottom or something.
Yeah.
Mikhail Wright.
You can turn them horizontal, Rob, if that helps.
Yeah, but then you can't see the player image very
well. You know, if we have to flip, we can flip, but it's
Romeo
easier for you
Dobbs.
To read it.
Trent McDuffie.
We're adaptable. Oh!
Kenny Pickett, number
wow.
10. Boom!
Wow.
Wow.
Back-to-back autos, Rob, here. We had the number one pick, and now we have the number one quarterback taking. Wow.
Two monster hits out of there.
That is huge.
And another Explode insert of Devin Lloyd. Holy cow.
Wow. Fire hands again.
Look at that. We almost won off of his jersey number.
Oh.
10.
You know what, though? We'll still take it.
Yeah. I don't
know. We'll still take it. Going to take it. A viewer's going to take it. We're happy to
Trey
hit it for
McBride.
You.
Ride. Sean Ryan. Effie Sewell. Louis Sign. Kayvon Thibodeau.
Nice.
Jeremy Ruckert.
Yep. Russ Cohen just did a feature on him.
Rookie Heat, Ahmad Gardner.
That's a good one. Saucy. Yeah. Sauce Gardner.
And Tyler Alger, Weekend Warrior numbered to just 50.
And that's a purple one. So
cool.
Yeah. That's nice.
Parallels.
Yeah. Yeah, so the Weekend Warriors, you get gold, you get silver, you get purple, and you get green. So,
and then Wildcard resolicited this product and said, yeah, we're going to go from 2 to 4 autos.
Why not? Yeah, I'm glad they did.
Mackenzie Milton.
It's a nice product.
John Menchie III. Brian Asmoa. Khalil Shakir. Andrew Booth Jr.
Yeah.
Jalen Naylor.
We got
Kennedy Brooks, number 50. Very nice.
All right.
Some solid players here. And nice. Look at that.
That's a nice card.
Smoking guns.
Yeah.
Cole Kelly, quarterback, number 200. I like that motif there. That's cool.
We're getting some low numbered cards here too. That's nice.
Very cool. Good looking set.
Really nice.
And our chase pack. Isaiah Spiller, number 250.
Nice.
Kair Elam.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
Trayvon Walker.
It's a good one.
Ooh. Jordan Davis.
Nice.
Mackenzie Milton. Brian Cook. Explode. Jeremy Ruckert.
What number is that? What's that number to?
That's number 8. Four of eight.
Wow. That's nice. New York Jets tight end.
Wow.
Oh, that's a good one, too.
Wow. Derek Stingley Jr., number 25.
Wow. That's a nice looking card, that Weekend Warrior.
This is what we're going to do.
Okay. We got some goodies in this one.
Yeah, we're going to take that Christian Harris auto.
Okay.
And I'm going to pair it up with their Jeremy Ruckert and the Derek Stingley Jr. And.
Okay. Kenny Pickett.
Trayvon Walker and Kenny Pickett.
Together?
No.
Okay. I was going to say together. Wow. That's a nice one.
And Kennedy Brooks. So 3-4 winners.
Okay. Kennedy Brooks, although.
Very nice.
That was a great box, Rob.
Fantastic. Special thanks to Wildcard for letting us get a sneak peek at that.
Wow. I would imagine the chat room is really excited over Kenny Pickett and Trayvon Walker.
Unbelievable.
Oh, the number one pick in the draft and the top quarterback selected in the draft. Fantastic.
Yeah, that's pretty much what you want, right?
That's all. I mean, if you get that in a box, you're feeling pretty good about yourself and your collection at this point. That's great. Kenny Pickett's been on fire in the preseason.
That's good to hear.
Yeah, he's been doing really good.
All right. Next up.
Pronunciations.
This is 2 mini boxes.
So this is almost going to be like the Star Wars thing, isn't it? Where, you know, we can pick one of the boxes and we're going to pull 2 super fractors. Is that what we're going to do tonight?
Wow. That would be something else.
I just remember this from last week where we had Star Wars Finest and we had to pick a box. So let's replay that, Rob. You had me pick a box and then I'm going to do the same setup. So we'll see what happens. We're going to go right side because that's what we did last week. So we're going to start with the right. We're going to keep everything cohesive here. That's what we're going to do. So box sets are 2 autographs per box, 4 refractor parallels, and 6 inserts. So let's see if we can pull some magic again. I have faith in Fire Hands, and we have the wizard in the background doing all the magic. So I think this is going to happen.
you crack me up. Well, let's give it a go.
You know, I think the audience at this point, Rob, believes. There's no reason why they shouldn't believe.
Eliex Moriba, rookie. Tony Cruz, Luis Muriel. Flip. Armindo Seeb.
I can see you, rookie. Rob. Yeah. The nice mirror.
Some blue.
Ooh.
An auto, apparently.
Yeah, that's maybe
David Neres. And that is going to be numbered to 150.
Nice. That's a nice one. Nice one. They used to see the audience used to tune in for the pronunciations. Now it's just the hits, Rob. That's all they care about now is the hits.
Sergio Ramos. Weston McKennie. Okay. Nico Gonzalez. Refractor. Nice Mohamed Kudos.
Yeah. We got a nice little crack, or
what is that?
What is that? Lava? That may be a lava.
Suso. He must be good. He's only got one name.
Yeah, they do that sometimes.
199.
So many of those soccer players have the one name. It's cool. I like it. If you feel that confident about yourself, just to have the one name, I like it.
Dominic S.
Ooh, that's a nice one.
Erlen Haaland.
And even if it's a base, it's still a good one of Haaland.
Luka Sukic.
You're making it work for this, Rob. You got to keep on flipping.
Mohamed Kudos. Oh, I know. And you know how much I love flipping. Yeah,
of course.
Prized footballers.
Who we got?
Canseco.
Jose? It sounds like a soccer player, Jose Canseco. I like it.
Neymar Jr. Kevin De Bruyne.
He's a great player.
Goncalo Inacio, rookie. Finest Futures, Lucas Nimcha.
It's close.
And Noah Mamba.
Not to be confused with Mbappe. He's Mbaba.
Number does 75.
Think La Bamba. Mbamba. La 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 and bamba.
Shola Shortire, rookie.
I like the name.
Karim Benzema.
Fantastic player.
Rookie he's Jonathan a nice up and comer. David.
Yeah, he's a nice up and comer.
Marcel Sabitzer.
They really make you work for this. Oh, another Suso. Yeah, we just got him.
Refractor.
Got two Susos. All right, we got to pull some heat here, baby. I'm not talking about the bench warmers either.
Brian Broby, rookie. Stefan Teagues, rookie. Kareem Adeyemi. Romelu Lukaku.
Yeah, we pulled him in another box before.
And prized footballer D-Lap.
Okay. Another one-namer.
Mini box number two.
Okay, let's see what we got in this one. So we got the one autograph out of the first box. So we're still waiting for the other autograph. Or the super fractor. I see some steam coming out. I see some steam coming out.
Sydney Raybigger, rookie.
Ooh, Jude Bellingham. He's a good one.
There's Nishima again. Brian Gravenberg. Rike Puig from Barcelona.
Okay. We got a number on that one or no number?
No number.
No number. It's not over yet, Rob. It's not over yet. That was the first pack.
Eduardo Camavinga.
He's a good one.
Another Suso.
Another one. Suso heavy.
Yao Felix.
Susu Studio.
Gavi, rookie.
Yeah, he's a good one.
Sydney Raybigger, rookie refractor.
Nice. Too bad that wasn't the Gavi.
Nuno Mendes, Pepe.
The other guy.
Tim Way. Jamal Musiala.
Mm-hmm.
Prized footballers. Gravenberg.
They're nice cards to prize footballers.
Adon Sancho.
Mm-hmm. Another bad player.
Liam Delap. Christian Pulisic.
He's a good player.
A little.
Yeah.
K.O. Jorge, rookie, finest futures.
Ah, what's this?
Danielle Malin.
Nice little shiny.
Very shiny. Number to 175.
175. Nice. We like the shiny.
This guy's pretty good.
Yeah, I'd say.
Another KO Jorge.
Okay.
Charles Day.
You got this.
Kettle Larry.
That sounds right.
Virgil van Dijk. And refractor Jamil Musiala. Excuse me. Last pack.
What we got here? We got one pack here.
Bruno Fernandez, Daniel Malin, Maxine.
LaCroix.
I know the last one. I'm looking at that first name. Maxence.
Maxence.
Pedre.
Yeah, he's good.
Sane. Prized footballers. All right.
Nice. We'll
give those two autos to one winner.
We got Neres and
Puig.
Puig. Or Puig, maybe.
I do with the. There they are. I buried them.
Not as good as the Star Wars last week, but.
Yeah. We set the bar a little high there.
But you know, the box before with Pickett and Walker, those were booms. Those were nice ones, especially the Pickett out of 10. Now this is fun. I know James was talking about this one.
Yeah, let's dive into some non-sport.
This is
with Marvel Metal Universe Spider-Man.
Let's pull a nice Venom or Spider-Man. Who's James's guy in Marvel? Curious. Sure.
This is Jane McLeod, who is the original creator of Metal Universe, has joined Upper Deck, and this is the first product she's done for them start to finish. So
wow,
you're going to see a lot of things that are probably familiar in a whole new way.
Sure. Always loved the Marvel characters. You more of a Marvel or DC guy, Rob?
Well, you know, I have my characters, I guess.
Sure.
I mean, my big one is Batman for DC.
Right.
But, you know, I guess a little bit more Marvel because I like Black Widow, Elektra, and the Punisher. So.
Okay. I love Venom. Venom is my guy. Spider-Man, obviously. And then you got Batman, obviously, on DC side. Superman, DC side. So many great characters. Can't go wrong with metal, though. This is always an awesome-looking product. Even the wrapper's cool. Look at that. Tough to open.
Wow, they are tough to open. Hmm. Gotta get them just right.
Wow. Secure in there. That's a nice thing. Look at those things.
Oh,
look at
man. That.
That's a nice-looking card. Wow. Those are beautiful. And that's just the base card. That's beautiful.
Silver Sable. Magneto.
He's cool. I like Magneto.
Mysterio.
Not Rey Mysterio. Oh, what's this?
Look at that. Red Wolverine, precious metal gem.
That's pretty sweet.
That's a precious. Is that numbered?
Yeah, that might be something.
Numbered to 100.
Yeah.
Wow.
Just like the original.
That's a big one. That's a boom.
Yeah.
That may be a boom, boom, shake the room. That's a nice one. And that's a Wolverine.
Yeah. They're saying, wow. NJ Sensation, dude, that's a huge card. I agree.
Boom. Yeah.
Big time.
That is beautiful. Wow.
Case hit?
That's a case hit?
I mean, do you have the sell sheet up?
He's calling me out.
Yep.
I love it. Let's see. I'm asking James. I'm sorry.
You're not just an observer here, you know?
I know. I love it.
Hydro Man. Madam Web. Oh, Hobgoblin.
Doesn't say anything about a case hit.
Ghost Spider.
It just says parallels include gold, red, green, PMGs, orange, turquoise, pink, purple, and
this
grandiose.
Is a purple parallel of Electro. Numbered to just 75.
Wow. That's a cool
Falcon.
One.
Falcon.
I like that one. Nice Falcon.
These are fun.
Oh, I see a...
Oh, there's your guy.
Oh, man. That's... Wow. That's big time. That's a gold one, too, Rob. That's gold.
Wow.
That's a gold Venom.
That's cool.
That is sweet.
Brain. Ronin. Oh, Morbius. Yeah.
Ah.
Toxin.
That's pretty sweet. It almost looks like Spider-Man at first. Just the pose. That's pretty cool.
That is
cool. What we got here?
Tinker.
Some that has that nice effect.
Action.
Yeah. No number on that one?
It's cool.
That may be like a, maybe the Grandiose.
Yes.
It's a Grandiose. Okay.
Yep.
See, I'm picking it up, James.
Love it.
Nick Fury. Mr. Negative.
No, we all need down the show.
Tinker.
What about Positive?
Miles Morales.
Oh, another Grandiose. Crime. I like the Grandiose. Master. Those are pretty cool. I like that effect. Another gold.
Black Panther.
Maybe golds are more common than I thought. You get three golds in a box. So you get three golds, you get one numbered base or high series parallel.
What's that?
Uh-oh.
Sketchbook.
It's a sketchbook?
No. But I mean, I don't know. That'd be cool if it was.
A gold Shriek.
Ah, that's cool.
Spidey.
Can't go wrong with Spider-Man. Another Spidey.
Superior Spider-Man.
Daily Bugle.
Daily Bugle.
Those are Daily Bugle headlines. It's a booklet design.
Oh, cool.
I really like that. That's fun. Oh, that is cool.
The booklet designs that look like a Daily Bugle newspaper, it says.
I like it.
Is that number? They said they have collect SP versions as well. No. So I'm not sure if that's short printed, but
I like that.
I'm watching the chat. Cool. We've got some savvy Spider-Man Metal Universe fans here, so they'll let us know.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's sweet.
Not Anthony Edwards, but we got Ant-Man.
Aunt May.
Is that considered a copper then, or is that just the?
I think it just may be the card because the guy's on fire, like Rob. But yeah, that Wolverine was a big hit.
D. Springfield in chat. Look at the color of the word metal. I think that's kind of the giveaway.
That's the giveaway.
Yeah.
So if metal is a different color, then it's obviously a parallel.
Yeah, that seems to make sense.
That's a cool card.
Alistair Smythe. Jackal. Chameleon.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
Venom.
That's Venom. That's pretty sweet. I like that Grandiose. Grandiose,
yeah,
are sweet.
That's fun.
That's fun. That really is fun.
Lizard. Or Lizarro. Lizard.
Lizarro. Sounds like a wrestler.
Flash Thompson, Maria Hill, aka Colby Smulders, Vulture, White Tiger.
Oh, that is sweet. That's a Carnage.
Carnage Grandiose.
Look at that card.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome.
That's like Stranger Things action right there. Wow, that's awesome card.
Black Tarantula.
Carnage is fantastic. Woody Harrelson actually played him in the second Venom.
Kangaroo.
Well, that's a cool card.
Sentry.
That S really like pops right there in the light.
Yeah, like it's almost coming through.
Right? That's pretty sweet.
Thor. There she is, Black Widow.
Ooh, what's Ooh. This?
Oh, one of the acetates.
No. Acetate palladium card.
Those are cool.
Palladium, really we cool. get one palladium in a box.
That's cool.
That is really neat. These are fun cards.
Flash Thompson. Yeah, they really are.
They did a great job on this. This product is fantastic. James, you were right. You talked about this in the beginning.
This is a great box. Fantastic product. Yeah.
Really is. Really well done.
Moon Knight. Black Panther.
That's cool.
Medusa. Gold Ant-Man.
Oh, that's neat. Ooh. Oh, what's this? Another one? Venom!
Cool.
We're supposed to get one palladium in a box. That may be numbered. Oh, wow, that nice. Looks like it's like a... Does that have like that crystal effect to it? No? Wow, that's a beautiful card.
That really is.
Wow. That is a killer card. I get excited over Venom.
Hawkeye.
There has to be Venom fans. I can't be the only Venom fan.
I thought Tom Hardy was really good.
He did a really nice job. I think he was voted the actor... Really hard to understand. The most hard to understand.
Crime Master. Black Cat. Tombstone. Wow. Nova. Look at that.
That's pretty cool. Wow. Ooh, sketch card.
What?
Sketch card on top of everything else we pulled?
What is this?
One of one sketch card.
What?
What a box.
Wow.
This is incredible.
Wow. One of one sketch card? Rob, back-to-back weeks with one of one?
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Wow. Ben Parker.
Wow. Wow. Yeah, I'm just going to say again, Rob, your fire hands, and I bow down. I know the wizard has something to do with this because he warned us about this box.
Another palladium.
What?
Chase says one per box. Or there's a cell
one
sheet.
Per box.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Blizzard.
Cool.
That is cool.
I think we have a hot box here. This is insane.
Mary Jane Watson.
That's a nice card.
Easy there, big boy.
You know, the Benchwarmer's got me steamed up here a little bit, Rob. You started it off, my man. I told you I was going to wear the robe.
Iron Fist. And our last pack.
I don't know what's going on. We got a one-on-one sketch. We had two super fractors last week. Rob spotting dimes. You know, I don't know what's going
on. The best card from the box is probably that PMG Wolverine.
I know, yeah, right?
Right? Luke That's Cage. The insane part of it.
Yeah.
J. Jonah Jameson. Doppelganger. Ironheart.
Ooh.
Mr. Sinister. And
there you go.
She-Hulk.
No, you don't want to mess with her.
All right, so this is what we're going to do.
She'll beat down the Benchwarmers.
All right, so obviously the one-of-one sketch card to somebody. Yeah,
right.
The PMG.
They're asking to see that sleeved and top-loaded.
Okay. PMG. The PMG sleeved and top-loaded?
The PMG, yeah.
Okay.
Wolverine PMJ. That's crazy.
That's a really nice card, yeah.
Let's see here.
So, James, you never told me who's your favorite.
Oh, I always liked the X-Men. So, I always liked X-Men. Wolverine okay. and Magneto and all them. But I like Spider-Man. Wolverine, I like them all. And Wolverine was my favorite as a kid. I'm not, like, the biggest fan of the art on that card. He's a little too...
Too crazy?
Juiced up.
Okay.
Just a little too bad about a little bit of a ding on there.
That's okay, though. Still probably get like a 9, maybe, if it's centered nicely.
Gambit in the chat. Yep, Stu Gunn. I like Gambit.
Gambit, a lot of people like him. Yeah. But getting Wolverine PMG, that's a nice one.
Yeah. Though. Oh, yeah.
It really is. Out of 102, Rob?
Yep.
Sweet.
That's beautiful.
Plus 3 palladiums, plus that cool, like...
Can I get a screenshot of that, Rob, really quick? With the Wolverine?
Yeah.
That cool newspaper booklet.
Oh, yeah, the Daily Bugle.
Right?
That was pretty sweet.
Great box, yeah.
Just lean it up a little bit more. There we go. Right there. Thank you. That's a nice card. Wow.
Oh, yeah, and there was one out of 75.
It was the, I forget who that was.
Electro.
Okay. Ah, Electro. Okay.
Let's see.
So we got the Spider-Man sketch card, the Wolverine PMG.
The 3 palladiums, I'm going to divide up the grandiose and the golds.
Okay. So
3 winners from there. 4, 5, and 1 winner is going to get the Daily Bugle and Electro.
Oh, that Electro looks really nice too. Gosh.
Yeah. So 3, 4, 5, 6 winners from this box.
Okay. Spider-Man, Wolverine, 3 palladiums, the golds, the
Grandiose.
So, and then the Daily Bugle and Electro.
That, yeah. And then 1 winner for both of these.
That was a great box. Wow.
So 3, 4,
6 winners.
6 winners. Yeah. What a box.
Wow. But, and not just your just average hits. We had some huge hits. So that's big time.
That was really fun. Thank you, Upper Deck.
Wow. After the finest soccer, that was a big boom, I would say.
Yeah.
Right?
For sure.
We start off with wild card. Well, the bench warmers, that started off the night nicely. And then wild card, really nice. Fias was good. But Marvel was huge.
Now we're going to switch to another worldwide
debut.
The most expensive
thing, right?
No. That, we've got a world debut box break of Panini Chronicles NASCAR. Four autographs or memorabilia cards in a box. Six packs.
Got a lot of racing fans watching tonight. That'd be pretty cool.
We always have racing fans.
You're a big racing guy, Rob.
Not NASCAR.
More Formula One, though, right?
Formula and Indy. But I do like that. I do like it when NASCAR races on road courses. Mm-hmm. Panini's really done a great job with their racing line.
I think Panini overall just does a great job with their cards.
So, again, Chronicles, we're going to get a look at a lot of varied content from Absolute, Ryan Blaney. Mm-hmm. From Select, Quinn Hoff. Jeb Burton, Crusade, Rookies and Stars.
A nice Bubba Wallace.
Titanium. Matt Snyder, Pedal to the Metal. Valiant, I think. That's cool. Black. Matt Mills. Ooh. Number 2, $199.
Nice.
Little acetate action. Nice. Denny Hamlin. So that's clearly Don Ross.
Right.
A little bit of a chunky.
Oh, okay.
Is that really?
We like the chunky.
Brittany Zamora Spectra.
Nice. See, Spectra fools you because their cards are so thick. You're thinking you're getting like a relic. But very nice cards. This is what makes this product fun, is because of all the different diverse cards in it, just all the different makes.
Yep. Wondering if we'll see anything new that they're testing out. That's always what I think is cool about
the testing.
Chronicles is you go, oh, I haven't seen that before.
Like what they did with Flux, and they made it
standalone. Yeah, exactly. This is the base design for Chronicles, Kyle Weatherman. Season ticket, Sheldon Creed.
Oh, Kyle Busch.
For Drive. Nice. XR, Chase Elliott. Justin Alger, Black. Do like that.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. Why not?
Number to 99, Red Parallel.
Nice. That's pretty cool how that happens, though. Especially if it's a good guy.
Clear, oh, that's Vision, cool. Danica Patrick.
Yeah.
That's numbered to just 50.
Wow. That's pretty cool. She has to still have a decent fan base, I would imagine.
And imagine a Spectra. Nope. See?
Oh.
Tasia. Stratus sheet metal card, Martin Truex Jr. So cool.
Really neat. Fool you. We like the chunkies, and we get the chunkies. We're just not sure what the chunky is until we flip it. We think we know, but we don't know.
Pinnacle.
A Pinnacle. Hain. That's the first I've seen a Pinnacle back around.
Josh Bilecki, Crusade. Natalie Decker, season ticket. That looks like a parallel, and it is. It's numbered to 199. Cole Custer, Zenith. Titanium, Garrett Smithley, Danica Patrick, Obsidian. Two acetate cards, it looks like.
Look at that.
Got one from clearly Donruss of Kyle Busch.
That's pretty cool.
And then Clear Vision, Martin Truex Jr.
We just got her another
Brittany Zamora Obsidian Auto.
Ah.
Fantastic.
Nice. We got a special card of her.
She's got a very strong fan base.
Does she? Yeah.
Yep. Limited, Dale Jr.
That's a good one. Another good one.
For Drive, Jeff Gordon. Ryan Blaney Purple.
Yeah.
Crusade. Yeah. Numbered to just 25.
Wow. Nice.
Jeff Gordon on the XR design. Tony Stewart on the black.
Hey, the black is sharp.
Smith Rookie on the Obsidian. What do we got here? Numbered to 49. Spectra Parallel, William Byron.
Beautiful.
And Clear Vision, Jimmy Johnson Acetate.
Really enjoy Chronicles. It's just fun to see all these different brands all together. It's just so fun. Have you seen Pinnacle outside of this product today, Rob? Like coming back?
Pinnacle Baseball 2013, I think, but not since then.
Right. Yeah. That's a surprise to me to see Pinnacle.
Phoenix, Kurt Busch. Select, Harrison Burton. Prism. Another lady racer with a huge following. Haley Deegan on the Zenith.
Yep.
Kurt Busch, Titanium. Pedal to the Metal. Brad Kozlowski. It's pretty cool. See how the metal, like the pedal design there? It's pretty.
Is that what we got here?
Nah, I wish.
Does that have a feel? Yeah. It looks like it has a feel, but
yeah, just a touch. Just
like a little notch in it. Yeah. Okay. Yep.
Cole Moore, Obsidian Auto. So that's an electric etch parallel, numbered to just 25.
Wow, that's a nice one. I like the etches. They're really cool. The different colored. Really nice.
And the King.
Of course. You have to include him in it.
Magnitude.
They're really cool. Can't go wrong with an acetate card.
Red Chronicles Parallel, numbered to just 99 of Spencer Boyd.
Nice.
Daniel Hemrick, Select. Kevin Harvick, Phoenix. Prism. William Byron. Alex Bowman. On the XR, Tony Breidinger, Obsidian.
Nice.
Brett Holmes, nice little auto. Pinnacle Auto.
On the Pinnacle.
And Bubba Wallace, Magnitude. All right, let's see. We're going to go two winners. One's going to get Brittany Zamora and Martin Truex Jr. The other one's going to get Cole Moore and Brett Holmes.
Got it. Pretty good. We got some nice numbered and nice autographs here. That's pretty good.
Also, I forgot to mention at the top of the program, we have new tech set up and did a test stream yesterday.
Yeah.
And so we did this month's Twitch break. We'll announce the winner at the end of the program. So the Twitch subscriber exclusive break for August was yesterday. And we broke a box of Mosaic basketball. So you're going to get all of the mosaics, including the blues and the golds.
Beautiful.
So all 12 of them. We'll announce that at the end of the program with everything else. Very cool. Nicely done on Chronicles. And then
you're doing very well tonight, Rob. Very, very well.
Certainly not least, we've got new this week. Select football, 12 packs, 5 cards per pack, 2 autos, and 1 memorabilia card per box.
This is the big one tonight. This retails for what, Rob?
It's currently selling for $1,700 a box.
Wow. And you guys can win the hits out of this box tonight for free. So keep watching. You never know what we're going to hit. And Fire Hands is all warmed up, my man. Wow. You're doing it.
For a second, I'm like, do you need 3D glasses for this card? This product.
Yeah, possibly. That would make it fun or annoying.
One of those.
One of those.
Kyle Murray on the packaging.
3D on the bench warmers would be interesting.
This is a family show, Chris.
You know.
James Winston, Nick Bolton, rookie. Ezekiel Elliott, red, numbered to 99. Silver, Antonio Gates. Rookie, Amon-Ra St. Brown.
Very good.
Imer Smith Marset for the Vikings. Marshall Faulk. Silver to a Tagovailoa.
Definitely good preseason.
On the horizontal design.
You like those.
Yep. James Winston. Silver. Russell.
Ah, see? They have them in the Seahawks. I saw other products, though. They have them in the Denver Broncos.
Well, this is 2021.
Yeah, that's true.
I like to get on them with the basketball, though.
Charles. <Those jerseys. laughs> Woodson.
We just got to get on them. Rookie? It doesn't matter if it's 2021. We're in 2022 now, right? So.
Sensations, oh, Trey cool. Lance. Yeah. Prism.
Pretty cool. Yeah.
Marshall Faulk, silver. Jalen Darden, rookie.
Yeah, the Sensations is a hobby exclusive, so. And the Zebra is the case hit in this.
Rookie Anthony Schwartz.
So we're hunting Zebra.
Terry McLaurin.
Oh, that's a cool one.
The red, white, and blue, Charles Woodson.
Yeah, great player.
number to 249. Rookie Tutu Atwell.
Yeah.
Field level prism. That's cool.
That is really cool.
Rookie Rondale Moore. Like our memorabilia card is there.
All right, a little chunky.
Rashad Bateman, rookie. Jared Goff.
Another sensation.
Mac Jones, rookie sensations.
It's a nice one.
Is it a parallel by any chance?
Okay. Well,
Jalen Darden. Gave us a little JD there. Gosh, that looks
Could he write it any smaller?
Yeah, it looks so crappy. Jeez.
Sometimes Jaylen, autographs ruin the card.
Instant non-fan. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a card that would be better without the auto.
Yeah. Really
like, oh, players. Number to 199. What could have been? If there'd just been more of an auto on there, or even bigger initials, you know?
Did he think the sticker was smaller?
I don't know. Just eat up the space, dude.
Yeah, you know.
Jamar Jefferson.
That's disappointing.
You get a memorabilia auto.
Yeah. That's,
you know, like,
put a little effort into it.
You know, if I'm Panini, I mean, I guess you got to have as many guys as you can for products, but man, I just want to fire that guy.
I don't know. That's
Chris Evans, rookie. Travis Etienne Jr., rookie. Kadarius Toney, rookie. Blue Hyper, numbered to 199. And then I think we're going to get a Jamal Lewis auto number to 199.
That's nice.
That is nice. See, if you're going to do your initials, dude.
Do that, yeah. Do it like that. At least Jamal's a seasoned vet. He's a retired player. He understands it. That's compared to a rookie.
He could fit those initials in the loop of his J.
Think about this for a second, Rob. Say you bought a box for $1,700.
Well, no one buys a box of this. You know what I mean?
Well,
it's a breaker product.
Yeah, it's a breaker product. But say you did, and you got that autograph, and it's supposed to be a big hit. I mean, that's just disappointing. But the Jamal Lewis makes up for it.
Oh, why can't guys just figure it out?
I don't know. Too much
and
effort.
I've been to the premiere. You know, Panini gives some really specific detailed instructions. And
are they all signed there at the premiere, or they're actually mailing these stickers out?
Depends
to
on
too.
There's only 40 people that go, right. So it depends on if they're one of the 40.
Sure.
Justin Fields, David Montgomery. Rookie selections, round one, pick 25, Travis Etienne Jr. See, I like that added data on the card.
That always helps, sure. He's coming back from injury, too.
Deami Brown, silver rookie. George Kittle.
Nice.
Feel some chunk in this one. We're going to get
all right. We like the chunkies.
Queenan Williams, Mac Jones, rookie.
It's always nice a good one.
That was a silver.
Right? That's the one you want.
Not bad. Daniel Jones, jersey swatch, number to 99.
We have some Giants fans in here who may or may not like that.
Michael Carter, silver rookie. Not bad.
No. It's a nice one.
Jonathan
He's a good one.
Taylor.
Yeah. So let's see, we're still zebra hunting here. That's a nice one. Tie-dye would be pretty cool too. We reach for the stars.
Joe Burrow. Deami Brown rookie regular. Jalen Hurts.
Nice.
Emir Smith Marset.
There you go. That's yeah. Sweet.
Rookie
That's
silver.
Your boy. Yeah. Another one for you.
Kimmy.
Hey. Yep.
Nwangu. That's the field level. You can tell.
Yeah.
Swirly there.
Swirl.
John Palmer. Rookie, DJ Moore, some purple, another rookie.
Hey,
oh, there he is again. Yeah. Keenan Nwangu.
You know, it's a Viking. I hear James getting excited.
75.
Yep. Love it.
And it's purple to match their colors. JC Jackson, silver.
Nice color.
And Tutu Atwell, rookie.
Yeah, so you want the field levels, they are the rarest. So. Field levels are nice.
Teddy Bridgewater. Devonta Smith, rookie.
Ah, there you go. There you go, James.
More.
What is going on? That's, Phenomenon.
Yeah, insert. Phenomenon.
Justin Jefferson. It's cool.
That's a cool card.
Yeah.
Aaron Jones, silver. Trey Lance. Oh, too bad that wasn't the silver.
Right. People would love that one.
Last pack.
All right. Maybe a zebra.
Nico Collins. Carlos Boogie Bashman, rookie.
I like the nickname.
Red and blue.
That's cool.
Kyle
Trask. Yeah, that's a good one.
Number to 149.
Possibly the heir apparent to Tom Brady. Possibly.
Silver rookie, Kenneth Gainwell.
Okay.
For your Eagles and J.J. Watt.
No zebra, but you know what? Not a bad box.
So the Jamal Lewis to one winner, and then I'll pair these up. The Jalen Darden and Daniel Jones.
Sure.
So two winners from that box.
Sure.
And that's going to do it for our box break segment for this evening. Clean up a little bit here.
Beautiful. Did a good one. Rob, you got one of one sketch. You got that PMG. You did a phenomenal job.
Awesome. Okay. Next up, video segment. We're going to take a quick break while you guys watch this. Again, from the floor of the National, thanks to Kelsey Schroyer, a look at a really unique concept. Unique in the sense that why is it taken this long to do it and do it right? Check out the Fan Stand Sports Card Vending Machine. And we'll be back and update the poll question and take a look at what else is hot in the shop.
All right, we're here at the 2022 National Sports Collectors Convention with Joe Daly from FanStand. Joe, this thing here is pretty cool. How does it work?
Okay, I'd be happy to show you. Okay, first of all, you can view the products through the window. They're all on this user interface screen. So we're going to scroll through here and find something that we like, something interesting. Let's see here. How about some Prism football? We got 2021 Prism football, blaster packs. We're gonna add it to the cart, check out. This is all a cashless system, so it's all credit, debit cards, Apple Pay, for example. So we'll put our card in, it'll authorize. So you guys may be wondering, how do we keep the cards from getting damaged? You've seen probably machines in the past drop the packs to the bottom of the machine. We got a carrier that's gonna come up, meet the floor level, and then we're gonna gently lay the pack into the carrier. It's gonna come down to the middle of the machine, door open.
Yeah, you're like my dad. My dad's setting up.
And there we go. We got our prison football pack. So it's pretty cool. We've had a lot of fun with this. Security wise, we've got these in indoor locations in malls and mass retail, like our pilot program with Kroger in the Atlanta region. We've had zero issues security wise, but the machine's very substantial. We got tuned heavy panes of glass, so it's not something you can just crack and enter and steal the product. But we're looking to expand. We've got big plans, both mall type locations throughout the country and mass retail partners, one starting with Kroger and talking with others. So looking to make big plans in the sports card industry and grow this business. So if you stop by booth 5090 at the National, we'd be happy to talk about the bandstand, and if you've got supply that you can help us with, we're looking at that. If you've got locations, we're looking at that. So come by and talk.
You're back. You're back. You can talk.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I take too long?
All good.
Just yelling at my kids.
You're yelling at your kids, you said?
Yeah, it was like, the dogs need water. The dogs are barking. Too much screaming.
The dogs even know you hit 101 tonight.
All right, let's hit that poll question, shall we? And update that. 165 of you weighing in so far. Numbers have tightened up. 53.3% saying, yes, I have purchased a print-to-order card direct from a manufacturer. 46.7% saying, no, 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 no. All right. Hot in the shop, I guess, huh?
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, in addition to, let's see, the other new releases that we just looked at, Best of Benchwarmer, Marvel Metal Universe, Spider-Man, and Chronicles Racing, and Select Football, got several other products in an absolutely loaded week. Yeah. And first up is Topps Clearly Authentic Baseball, which delivers one encased autograph signed on card in every box, showcasing game-changing rookies, active stars, and all-time greats on an alluring array of acetate cards. All autographs are signed on, directly on card, and encased. Plus, collect the rainbow of randomly inserted color parallels throughout and chase rare case hits that deliver superstar signers on iconic, reimagined, or luminescent technology. This is always a fun product because who really doesn't like acetate, right?
Everyone does, right? Yeah.
Yeah, it's just one of those things that you love it. The configuration, very popular with case breakers, 20 boxes, one pack, one card, quick rip. New this year, though, Generations Now autographs, Clearly Authentic 87 Tops autographs, 1955 reimagining, and Love Me Some Tops Tech on acetate.
Absolutely.
Very cool. Checklist is up, and this is in stores now as we speak.
All right, next up is 2021-22 Topps Inception Overtime Elite Basketball Cards. It delivers two autographed or autographed relic cards, plus two parallels and three base cards in every box. Topps Inception provides collectors with the first ever autographed relic hybrid product from Overtime Elite, with this beautifully designed set featuring all of the league's top players. You get two autographed cards and two autographed relic, or two autographed and two, or let me say it one more time. Two autographed or autographed relic cards per box, two parallels, and three base cards. So in this, you get base autographed parallels. You get magenta, you get red, you get blue, you get aqua, and also the Inception one of one. Also look for Inception silver signings, Inception autograph relic cards, Inception autograph jumbo relic cards, Inception autograph team name book cards, Inception dual autograph relic book cards, Inception autograph game ball relic cards, game day gear autograph relic cards, and also collect the entire 100 card base set. The checklist is on the website. Check it out. Overtime Elite Inception Basketball from Topps. Check it out this week.
Absolutely. Check it out. Next up, we have from Leaf, one of their most popular products year in and year out, Leaf Metal Draft football cards. And two different configurations again this year. Hobby, which is going to deliver five autographs signed on card in every box, or Jumbo, which is going to have nine autographs signed on card and one pre-production slabbed proof autograph card numbered one of one in every Jumbo box. Once again, this release is going to focus on the best offensive skill position players and potential future defensive stars of the 2022 NFL Draft. In addition, look for the first ever inclusion of the very top NCAA football future NFL draftees. So again, two configurations, each loaded with a variety of parallels to chase, including they call them multiple levels of prismatic, including wave, crystal, and mojo.
Nice.
Plus lots of themed insert sets like award winners, armed, state pride, tenacious, touchdown kings, and more. Plus those great pre-production slab proof autograph cards numbered one of one in jumbo boxes. So a lot of variety for people to chase in terms of either configuration that they'd like to purchase, or if they want to get in on a break, because breakers really do like the extra jumbo configuration. The checklist is up on GoGTS.net for this as well. And that's that.
Nice. Next up is 2021-22 Topps Chrome Paris Saint-Germain Soccer Cards. It delivers 20 autograph cards numbered, 20 base cards numbered in every box. For the first time in history, Topps has partnered with Paris Saint-Germain for an exclusive high-end trading card set, a crossover between Europe's biggest stars and Topps' iconic chrome brand. This 40-card set is stocked with rare hits and on-card autographs, including the first Kylian Mbappe officially licensed on-card autograph. Limited to only 270 sets. So check it out this week, especially if you are a Paris Saint-Germain fan or if you want to try to hit that first ever Topps Kylian Mbappe autographed on-card card. That's phenomenal. So again, check it out. The checklist is on the GoGTS website. Check it out this week.
Next up, we have Formula One meets Topps Attack in the form of 2022 Topps Formula One Turbo Attacks. Featuring all new cards from the Gladiators of Speed, this product was a huge hit overseas and now comes to the United States for 2022. The driver lineup includes two of the finest of their generation, Lewis Hamilton and Max Verstappen, plus rising stars like Lando Norris, George Russell, and Mick Schumacher. Look out for exclusive cards, parallels, and ultra-rare limited edition cards. Formula One has never been more popular and shows no signs of slowing down now. There's two different retail configurations. Retail display, which is 24 packs with 10 cards each, and then collectible tins with 66 cards in 12 packs. Ultra-rare gold and diamond limited edition, plus mirror foil parallels, including record breakers, Topps awards, race winners, and more. The tin really for $14.99.
Yeah.
My way is the way to go. You get four limited edition cards plus two exclusive cards in each tin. And those are going to be Future Legends, Super Elite, or Hall of Fame. Tops roars into F1 with Turbo Attacks.
Nice. 2022-23 Topps Road to Nations League Finals Match Attacks Soccer. This incredible all-new Road to UEFA Nations League Finals set features all the biggest superstars in international European football, as well as the breakthrough talents of the future. The stunning new card design is complemented with an abundance of special insert cards, as well as a rare and ultra-rare surprises, making Match Attacks 101 the ultimate international football collection for 2022. The configurations are three of them, Display Box, Mega Tin, and Mini Tin. The all-new product includes Topps Index Rankings, new Parallel Series, new Limited Editions, rare Chrome Chase cards, ultra rare world class autographs, and much, much more. This is a fantastic product for all the soccer fans out there, especially international soccer fans. So check this one out. This one looks like a keeper this week.
All right. And last but not least, those Rugrats. You know them, you love them. Garbage Pail Kids come to Shiny in the form of 2021 Topps Chrome GPK. With like eight refractors in every box. Always classic GPK Original Series 4 set. Gets a fresh coat of chrome with this release. Collect the entire 100-card base set consisting of all 42 Original Series 4 pieces of art, as well as six all-new art pieces of classic GPK characters. Look for rare artist autograph cards, C-name variations, and exclusive parallels. Plus, as you would imagine, you know, you're going to get in those refractors lots of different colors, including new for this year, yellow, numbered to 275. Yellow Wave, also numbered to 275. Aqua Prism, numbered to 199. There's a couple hobby-only versions in black, orange, and red, numbered to 99, 75, and 5, respectively. And then one more new one, Rose Gold, numbered to just 25. Checklist is on GoGTS.net. And that's a look at what's hot in the shop this week.
It was a low of the week, Rob.
It really, really was. All right, we're going to put Chris to work drawing some winners while you guys watch this. Ty Wilson at Breaker Culture and host and producer of Chasing Cardboard talks about questions related to what to do when it's time to sell your collection. Watch this, and we'll be right back to announce tonight's winners and wrap it up.
eBay store, okay? All right, so the thing that we often overlook, and the thing that I think probably we get more objections on than anything else, is this idea that a collection that you buy will sell. What I mean is, let's say I go pay $1,000 for those cards and I get 1,000 cards. The assumption is that all of a sudden you snap your fingers and those cards sell. But the reality is, in lots of bulk collections, in most bulk collections, 90%+ of those cards will take months and months to sell. There is a lot of stagnant inventory, a lot of stagnant players and years in sports cards that, unless you give it away, you're gonna have to just wait for the right buyer. And oftentimes when I'm going in to look at collections to buy, I'm thinking, okay, here's the cards that I know I can sell really quickly. But more importantly, here's the cards and the part of the collection that I know will not sell quickly. And that's equally important, if not more important, because the last thing you want, and probably what kills a lot of sports card businesses or flippers or, you know, guys that are collecting and also kind of and selling on the side, is they build up this mountain of stagnant inventory. And that stagnant inventory, that dead weight, that money that's tied up into cards that don't move, will just eat away at your bottom line. And honestly, you don't want those cards stacking up in your house or your storage or whatever anyway. And so, like, understanding that it's really hard to move cards. I mean, I just can't express this enough. It's common economic principles here, supply and demand, right? Hot stuff obviously is gonna move quick. And stuff that's really good, top end players, top end sets, you're going to pay closer to comps, you know, within 20% of comps and a lot of that stuff. But everything else, you have to understand that your cards will not move for months. And so the question always becomes for at least sellers is, do they want to take $10,000 from Ty and not have to necessarily pay, you know, fees on it, put in the time, there's maybe a different kind of tax code, or maybe sell it for $15,000 to $20,000, and put in the hundreds of hours of work and slowly let that stuff turn over and inventory and all that thing. Like that's usually the battle that's taking place in a seller's mind. And so you need to understand, like, how much is your cash worth? Because if your cash is dead and sitting there and not flipping and not working for you, then look, me making a lowball offer to somebody might not be a lowball offer to them. And it's definitely not a lowball offer to me, because I value my cash being put to work. And if it's not working very quick on dead or kind of less exciting inventory, then I have to value it differently. So just understand that. And again, I'm looking at this from the mindset of I want to be fiscally responsible so that we can continue putting out these episodes and buying collections and providing for our families. And so that's the way I typically view kind of stagnant inventory and the reality of cards not moving. Okay, number three, people often forget that when you sell cards online, and you think, oh man, it's so easy. Just go sell those cards online. It's really, really easy. It's not easy. You gotta pay taxes. Profit, revenue is taxed. And that's always something that hits home, especially for guys that don't sell online. And then they think, okay, I'm gonna go sell online. And they sell over $600, which is the threshold now. And then they get that, you know, those tax forms at the end of the year, and they realize they gotta pay taxes on that. And that's minimum, you're gonna pay 15% on all that revenue. But if you're a high income earner, you're probably gonna pay even more on those taxes, especially for those that didn't keep good records on those cards and are able to kind of balance out what they paid and stuff. Just keep that in mind, like profit is taxed. So selling in one fast, easy transaction is a little lever, again, as a buyer you can use as a negotiation tactic, and something as a seller that you can use to your advantage as well, okay?
We're done, go.
All right, we are back. And we have, how many winners do we have to announce, Chris?
Well, it's a lot of winners. We had, I just pulled 18 plus the swag bag winner, and then we also had the Twitch break winner as well, but including in that was the BCW display frame. So we had a lot going on tonight. So we had swag bags, frames, Twitch winners, and all the box breaks that we had. It was a phenomenal night here. And even Rob, you have to applaud Rob. The chat, I want to see hearts, or I want to see thank yous. I want to see fire. I want to see everything, because Rob again struck that Marvel box was fantastic. Everyone has to love that. A one of one again. And then also that PMG, the Wolverine. Rob, take a bow, my man.
Thank you.
Beautiful stuff.
All right. If you hear your name called, you're going to do a few things for us. You're going to email the show, GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. Correct. You're going to send us your name, your mailing address, your Twitter handle, and what you won. Four things to GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. All right.
Not hard for you to get your prizes. So should we start with Benchwarmers, Rob?
Sure.
All righty. Let's go with the Benchwarmers, and we'll start with the Brandy Moses autograph. And Brandy Moses goes to...
I thought I was sending them both to one person, or no? Did I say no?
You said split the two. You said one gets one and another one gets the other one.
Oh, yeah, and I'm going to divide up.
Yep, rep. Yep.
Yeah, got it.
So okay. The Brandy Moses goes to @Sam2BSC. I'll say it one more time, @Sam2BSC. And then the Sydney Margolis, the most downloaded woman at one point in her career, goes to @LilQuack1976.
As congratulations. As James said while we were watching the video, the most downloaded woman in AOL history.
That's a phenomenal feat to be the most downloaded woman, I guess, anywhere. So, you know. She did something right. 2022 wild card Matt draft will go with next. And we will go with Christian Harris, Jeremy Rucker, and Derek Stingley. That goes to at the real Brizzo. Congratulations, Brizzo, as Rob is holding him up right there. And we'll go with the Kennedy Brooks autograph next. We'll save the two best for last. Kennedy Brooks goes to at Janice Trage. So Trage is spelled T-R-A-J-E. Congratulations, Janice. The Trayvon Walker autograph goes to at Skoll Gottberg. Congratulations. That's out of 50 there, that Trayvon Walker. And then the big one, the Kenny Pickett autograph. I believe that was out of 10. And that goes to at Islander fan 1940. Congratulations. It's a great pick. Next up, we got 2021-22 Topps Finest Champions League Soccer. And we had the two cards right there that Rob's holding up, the Neres and the Puig autographs. And that goes to at Ricky Hedrick 23. Congratulations, Ricky. And now this was like the big box. This was like all kinds of hits. The 2021 Upper Deck Marvel Metal Universe Spider-Man. This was a phenomenal box, and we just talked about it not too long ago. We'll go with the Daily Bugle and Electro first. And that goes to at Moncus 404. Congratulations. We'll do the Grandiose inserts next, the parallels. And that goes to at Sooner PCV. You get all the Grandioses. The golds, they go to at Levin Elson. Congratulations. The three palladiums, they go to at Ferg 209.
Actually, you and I miscommunicated a little bit.
Okay, I did something wrong.
No, it's okay.
Okay.
It's okay. I'm going to take the golds and the palladiums and the grandiose, and I'm going to split them up between those three people.
Gotcha.
So we're going to call those
bag of nuts.
Marvel inserts 1, 2, and 3. And say the winners of Marvel inserts 1, 2, and 3 again.
I apologize for that.
No.
Let's see. Marvel inserts. Take the apology, Rob. No worries. Marvel inserts 1. That will go to at Ferg 209. Marvel inserts 2. That will go to at Levin Elson. Marvel inserts 3. That will go to at Sooner PCV. So again, Rob will mix those up.
Yeah,
so
that way everybody gets a palladium.
Yeah.
Everybody gets a grandiose. Everybody, you know.
That makes more sense then. Yeah. Thanks, Rob. I appreciate that. Okay, the next up will be the Spider-Man sketch card of someone that looked like Spider-Man. I missed that one. But
I think he's like, I mean, Venom.
Is that like Venom? It looks like Venom with the tongue. Like Venom going into Spider-Man almost.
What that is up top on his head is that it's the mask
it's Spider-Man
ripping open.
Yeah, because
it's Carnage.
Remember,
NJ Sensation in chat, Carnage.
That's Carnage. Huh. Okay. Well, that one goes to at Pass IT Promo. Congratulations. It's a pretty cool card, though.
This
really cool card.
Really cool.
And this is the big one. This was the Wolverine PMG out of 100. And this one goes to at Zach in Philly. Congratulations, Zach. You got that big Wolverine. That's phenomenal. And we'll go to 2022 Panini Chronicles Racing next. And we'll go with the Brittany Zamora and the Martin Truex Jr. And that one goes to at Inwood We Trust. Congrats. And then the Cole Moore and Brett Holmes. That will go to at Jeremy Wolston. Congratulations. Some big winners here tonight, Rob.
Yeah.
2021 Select NFL Football. We had two winners from that great box. And the first winner will be the Jalen Darden Auto. and the Daniel Jones relic. And that'll go to @Ryan_C07. Congratulations, Ryan. And then the Jamal Lewis autograph, that will go to @BigCowboy22. So he seems like he's an Emmett Smith fan, but he got a Jamal Lewis autograph. So hopefully you're happy with that one there. So next we'll do the BCW display frames that we were going to give away last week, but we felt like we'll keep it for this week. And the winner for that goes to @Squiggle_D. I like the name, @Squiggle, Rob.
Mm-hmm. Longtime viewer.
Yeah. And then we have the national swag bag full of all kinds of goodies. We gave away two of these last week. We have one for tonight, which is so great because look at that bag. It's stuffed. And that goes to @NY_loves_DDUB. Congratulations. And now we also have one more winner, and this was from the Twitch break that we did. I believe that was yesterday. And that winner is NJ Sensation. Congratulations, NJ. Everyone, congratulations. And again, to claim your prize, email us at gogtslive@gogts.net. gogtslive@gogts.net. Include your full name, Twitter handle, mailing address, and also what you have won. We appreciate everyone who watched tonight. And again, congratulations on winning your prizes.
Have an update on that sketch card. Opa Klingon style in chat. Looked it up. It's toxin.
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 All right. Nice.
Okay. Nice.
We have the best viewers. Look at them. They're Johnny on the spot.
It's fantastic. They're curious too. We were curious.
Exactly.
So nice.
You know, sometimes you're able to tell, oh, that is definitely Spider-Man. Sure. That is definitely Black Widow.
But that art, though, it did look like Venom coming up through Spider-Man.
Right?
Because
Venom
was actually attached to Spider-Man at one point. So, yeah.
Well, I want to thank Brian Wallace at Benchwarmer, Daniel Atkins at Wildcard, Jonathan Matros at Tops, Paul at Upper Deck, Scott Prusha at Panini America, and all of the team, Ken and team at BCW for a look at those frames last week. And just one quick programming note, we're going to be off next week for the long Labor Day weekend. So everybody, happy Labor Day. Hope you don't have to labor at all, if not too much. So enjoy. And in the meantime, we'll be back in 2 weeks with a brand new episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Thanks to Chris, as always, and James Gale behind the scenes with the brand new tech setup. Nicely done, James.
Great job. Yep.
You guys know what to be doing out there. Always be collecting. Happy Labor Day. We'll see you soon. Good night.